Let's abuse some 555 timer ICs. Here I have two 555 timers configured in monostable mode. Now it would be nice if the second monostable could be triggered automatically after the first one has reset. We can accomplish this by using a 100 nanofarad capacitor to link pin 3 of the first 555 to pin 2 of the second 555. If I trigger the first monostable, when it resets itself, the second monostable will be triggered. The exact capacitance to use in the link will depend on the other component values in the circuit and the type of 555 timer being used. These are NE555 chips. We can extend this chain to arbitrary lengths. Here are four monostables chained in a closed loop, passing an active token. For obvious reasons, you should not use 555 timers this way. There is no guarantee that exactly one monostable will be active. There might be more than one on power-up, or none at all. Momentarily grounding pin 2 of one of the 555s will initialize the chaser circuit properly. This is why it is far better to use a CD4017 IC with a 555 in astable mode for this application. Since loading down pin 3 will alter the capacitance and risk losing the token, we are limited to using this sequencer for blinking some LEDs in an attractive way. I tried animating a green walking man, but I really suck at flipbook animations. We can introduce more 555 timers to act as buffers. To avoid loading down pin 3, the second row of 555s are connected to 10K pull-ups and pulled to ground by pin 7. This configuration also allows us to level shift. The top row of 555 timers are on a 5-volt rail, while the bottom row of 555 timers are on a 12-volt rail. Why would we want to do this? We can now use this circuit to drive a 12-volt bipolar stepper motor. The NE555 can drive up to 200 milliamps. Again, for obvious reasons, you should not use 555 timer ICs to drive motors. They lack the current limiting safety features of proper motor drivers. Were I to physically stop the motor from turning, the back EMF will drop to zero and most of the 12-volt supply will be dropped across the NE555 current drivers on pin 3 and risk damaging the chip. So I've just demonstrated how to abuse a bunch of 555 timers to sequence some blinking LEDs and to spin a shaft. We can now make a crude kinetic sculpture. With just 4 frames of animation, a green hopping frog made for a more convincing animation than the walking man. I used some leftover Christmas wrapping paper to form a scrolling background for the frog. I consider the result to be rather mixed. It is difficult to see the animated frog, even in a very dimly lit room. I should have used a lighter colored wrapping paper with a less contrasting pattern on which to project the animation. And of course, I should not have used 555 timers exclusively. An Arduino with a motor shield would have been much more suitable.